One of the key factors contributing to the disaster due to natural hazards such as earthquake is the vulnerability of structures. This vulnerability can be reduced by proper engineering design and detailing. And today we talk about the role of concrete confinement in reducing this vulnerability. If, for example, we take the example of a column which has vertical reinforcement and also transverse reinforcement and ties, then the ties and the transverse reinforcement provide the confinement to the concrete. This confinement significantly increases the ability of the column to carry larger compressive load without breaking suddenly. This is often called the increased ductility because of the confining effect. So we can see that confinement will significantly improve ductility. Now, if we compare two columns, one which is confined by transverse reinforcement and one which is unconfined, we can clearly see that the capacity of the confined column to carry larger load with larger deformation without breaking is higher. This is very significant when the structures are subjected to lateral loads such as earthquake. And because of the bending produced by lateral loads, the cross sections of the columns and beams deform, and this deformation causes tension on one side and compression on the other side and rotating the cross section, which is called curvature. And this produces tensile and compressive stresses. And this curvature capacity is a critical contributor towards the performance of the frames for lateral loads. And once we have a confined column, then the curvature capacity is large and we have a larger ductility. So the frames can carry larger loads before breaking. This is especially important when the frames are subjected to repeated loading and unloading, such as an earthquake, in which case this capacity to deform without breaking adds energy dissipation into the system. This at the same time causing some damage. This damage reduces the actual capacity, but still improves the overall capability of the structure to carry loads, and its performance is enhanced from breaking suddenly to resisting the loads with greater deformability and greater energy dissipation. This combined effect then reduces the risk to disaster. And the confinement improves the ductility, and ductility then in turn improves the energy dissipation, and this energy dissipation leads to a better performance. This better performance obviously then can reduce the vulnerability, and reduced vulnerability can reduce the risk and save the buildings and increase the resilience of the structures as the community.